Welcome to Chemistry Lover. Today in this video, I am with another question from CSIR-NET exam, and this time this is a very important question. I already discussed about this topic in my previous videos. If you want to watch that video, you can watch by going through the link which is given in the description section, where I explained this thing in detail. But here I will solve this question with that concept, and the concept is nothing but the iodolactonization, or in general halolactonization. So you can see this is the question given. This is a carboxylic acid which is attached to some alkene, but not directly. And then it is treated with, first it is treated with NBS, N-bromosuccinamide, and then it is treated with some strong base like potassium tartbutoxide. So what will be the product among this all four options? Now if you know the iodolactonization mechanism little bit, you will discard option A and option B because they are not lactones. In iodolactonization or halolactonization reaction, what happens? Lactone is formed at the end of the reaction. So these two are not lactones, so they are ruled out. Then we are left out with only option C and D. Now what will be the correct option between C and D? So for that we have to do the mechanism in short. So what happens in any halolactonization reaction is, here you have given NBS, right? So NBS is N-bromosuccinamide. So this is the structure of N-bromosuccinamide. This is the structure of N-bromosuccinamide, which is a brominating agent. And if you have alkene, and if you treat this alkene with N-bromosuccinamide, now there are two reactions of N-bromosuccinamide. There is the allylic bromination, but there the N-bromosuccinamide is used in CCl4 and radical, that is a radical pathway. But this here you can see there is no such pathway is mentioned, so it is a general bromination reaction. It is a simple bromination reaction over alkene. So what will happen, this alkene will attack on this bromine and you will get this bromonium ion. So you will get this bromonium ion, and now here you have this carboxylic acid group. So now next question is, what will happen next? Now it is very interesting to note that here no stereochemistry is mentioned, the whether this hydrogen is above the plane or whether it is below the plane, that is not mentioned in the question. But in the answer you can see there is a stereochemistry mentioned. So how can you predict the stereochemistry? So here is the important thing, is that it doesn't matter whether this bromination or this bromonium ion formation takes place over from the top face or the bottom face. The attack from this lone pair will always take place from the back side, right? So let's say it attacks from the top face, right? So let's say it attacks from the top face, the bromination is taking place from the top face. So then if this attack takes place from the bottom face, what you will get? From the backside attack, you will get a product like this. Which, and you can see here you have the bromine, right? So here you have the bromine and you get this. Now you can see the hydrogen, where the hydrogen will be, the hydrogen will also be above the plane. So you can see this hydrogen is also above the plane, because so here the hydrogen is below the plane, but you can see the backside attack is occurring. This is same like SN2 reaction, and if the SN2 reaction occurs, then inversion of stereocenter will occur. So if inversion of this stereocenter occurs, then the hydrogen which were at the below of the plane, it will come above the plane because inversion is occurring. So now you can see both this hydrogen and this bromine, they are in the same side, and here it is simple, like, so here you have plus charge. Now it is basically this lone pair will push and this bond will go here. So what you will get here, you will get this keto group here, and this will now be neutralized. Now here comes the very interesting step. To get this product, you can see the elimination has to occur from here. This hydrogen elimination has to occur to give you this product, but it requires a syn elimination. And in E2 reaction, you know that syn elimination is not favored due to several factors. Steric reasons, the transition state is not energetically lower. There are the reasons, and that's why this hydrogen cannot take part in elimination reaction. Whereas you can see here you have two hydrogens. One is below the plane, one is above the plane. Now this below the plane hydrogen, this and this bromine, they are anti-periplanar to each other, and this hydrogen can undergo elimination when you treat with tert-butoxide. So tert-butoxide will go, this bond will go here and this will go. So this is E2 elimination reaction, and that will give you product C. So you can see how you have to do this particular question. So this step is very important. You can see you have to consider this inversion now, and again you can see this hydrogen, this is also above the plane. Now if we consider that this bromonium ion is on the bottom phase and the attack is occurring on the top phase, then again we would conclude to the same result. That doesn't matter. So that's how you have to solve this type of questions. And another thing is that in place of NBS, they can give you NIS, which is N-iodosuccinamide, or simple bromine or iodine. You have to just consider the bromonium or iodonium, any halonium ion formation. That is the important thing. So I hope that this video will help you. And this iodolactonization or halolactonization topic, this is a very, very important topic. Every alternative year question comes from this topic. So you must prepare this well. Thank you for watching. Best of luck for you.